for a small amount of your, this is about buying insurance. It was the same reason why in 2007 and 8, the folks that bought simple insurance bought some CDS.
You might as well buy gold. I mean, at least gold's got a 10,000-year record of being a store of value. I mean, I think that's the other thing Buffett's saying. There's no reason to think this is a store of value.
I think that's a fair point, but I think these are not exclusive decisions. And, for this younger class of entrant into the market, they probably don't want to buy gold. In fact, they don't want to buy gold, and they want to buy something that's much more digital and reflective of their values.
How do you feel, though, about the idea that Charlie sort of suggested that there's something sort of scummy about that, or that there's a lot of scum in the crypto world right now?
So this idea of gold versus crypto assets and why cryptocurrency is superior, he doesn't really go into a deep analysis, so I'm going to kind of break this down. So the issue with gold is custodianship and fees. I had a Monex account. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar, but it's a huge gold broker. And so you can buy gold. They're gold. They'll hold it to you. You have like a contract. But the issue is, obviously, one thing that's a big, big problem, he doesn't mention this, is that the government can seize that asset, right? Monex is regulated by the government. So if some BS lawsuit happens, or if anything, let's just say I'm in a country and I speak against the government, boom, they can just seize my gold. Obviously, I can put it in my safe, but then I have to worry about people coming and trying to break into it. And like I said, if I have, let's just say, $100,000, $200,000, $500,000 worth of gold, it becomes a lot harder to store. And like I said, if I go the institutional route, it can obviously be seized and there's nothing I can do about it. With crypto, I could be hiding it on a piece of paper. The keys can be on paper. The keys could be in my laptop, in my Trezor wallet. I mean, there's so many ways to store it, and it could be billions of dollars, and you don't have to worry about it. And the best part, where he doesn't mention it, it's easy to send it. I mean, what if I want to send my gold to my cousin, I don't know, Jagdish in India? I mean, it's just a lot more complicated. So yes, gold has a great history, and you can wear it, you know, you can have some bling and, you know, look awesome with it. But yeah, crypto is superior. There's just so many benefits, and it's evolved. And yeah, maybe it's just because millennials like it, because it's the coolest thing in the world and it's a millennial thing. But I mean, just when it comes to fundamental storing and sending, I mean, it's just superior to gold. And I like things that are low key and not transparent, or what, like, you can't see. So if you gave me the option of wearing $50,000 of gold or having $50,000 of crypto in my wallet, I mean, give me the crypto, man. I don't want anyone to know. So let me know your thoughts about this crypto versus gold, and I will cover the rest on the billionaires that have been trolling Bitcoin. Thank you very much for watching, and I will talk to you guys soon.